welcome to my second ever Facebook Live. I'm here today to celebrate the release of The Darkest Promise, my newest book. I'll just grab a copy and show you. Yay! Last time I did this, I gave you a tour of my office, and since you've already been there, done that, I thought I would walk you through a typical writing day. So I start by putting on my uniform right here, just like so. It's a little confining, but what are you going to do? It's a uniform. You have to wear it. Then I sit down. I take care of my emails, and I get started working on my book and whatever I'm working on at the time. And I constantly text Jill Monroe, what do you think about this? I need to brainstorm that. And so she's so wonderful and always helps walk me through some things. So anyways, I'm so excited today to come to you about The Darkest Promise, and I thought that we could hold a contest. So all you have to do to enter is like my Facebook page and post a question and during this video, and we're going to draw 10 people to receive one of these, a printout of the first chapter of The Darkest Promise with my notes. And then also one lucky person will win a backlist Lords of the Underworld title in hardback. Any of the titles, that anyone that you want, the winner's choice. And so yeah, look at these beautiful things. I mean, what a gorgeous collection. I'm just so proud and so happy and so thrilled with each and every one of these. So anyway, oh yes, and I cannot tell you about my writing day and not tell you about my favorite snack right now. while I'm writing my books now, I eat one of these a day or more, sadly. And I actually got started on this addiction while I was in Holland. They gave me one of these delicious candy bars, and I have been hooked ever since. So thank you, Harlequin, Holland, for that. I love it. And I've got to take this off because I'm already overheating. Okay, what else was I gonna tell you? Oh, yes, okay, for those of you who pick up The Darkest Promise and give it a read, I would be so incredibly grateful if after you're done reading, if you would go to Amazon and other online retailers and post a honest review. It can be as long or as short as you like. But the more reviews authors have, the more algorithms that kick in, and so I would just be so beyond grateful to you guys. So do we have any questions?
Well, tomorrow is Joy Marie's birthday, and she is treating herself for her birthday with Darkest Promise.
Oh, I love that. Happy birthday, first of all, and that just thrills me to my soul. So thank you so much, and I hope you enjoy it.
Someone is saying greetings from Perth, Australia, and another person wrote in what I think is French.
Hello, everyone. It's so wonderful to have you. And the voice you hear on the other side of the phone is my bestie, Jill Monroe. So,
people want to know what, without giving spoilers, okay, what was your favorite scene to write in The Darkest Promise?
My favorite scene to write in The Darkest Promise is probably every scene with Cameo and Lazarus, because one of my favorite things about writing this book altogether is the fact that I really went back to my romance roots. The romance is the central focus of this book from start to finish. And so she's possessed by the demon of misery. To get past that, he has to really niggle at her, poke and prod at her to get her angry. It's the law of displacement, you know, the water drips into the jar and then suddenly the water explodes and now you have this empty vessel that can be filled with something else. And I know that there are so many, I'm alluding to so many naughty things right now, and I'm not meaning to, but he just likes to get rid of the misery so that he can make her angry, and that anger can lead to some delicious little sexy times. So everything with Cameo and Lazarus is my favorite.
Okay, it's also Courtney's birthday today, and she says her husband bought her your book.
Oh, I love your husband, first of all. That's so wonderful. And happy birthday, Courtney, to you as well.
And Wendy Higgins, our special princess.
Hello. Yes, I love Wendy Higgins. She is so fantastic. So hello, and thank you for tuning in.
Okay, someone wants to know if you are going to write a spinoff with all of the children.
I do not have a spinoff with the children planned right now. That doesn't mean that it won't happen or in the future, but right now that is not in the works. Right now they are just children to me, and I want to give them a little time to grow up. So,
okay, this is, so many people ask this question, okay. And I bet you already know what it is, but when will William get his book?
Okay, so I asked my publisher yesterday, in fact, it was the very first thing that I emailed and asked, if I could talk to you guys about my next Lords of the Underworld book, who the leading characters would be, because who I thought I was going to write about, and I've even told a few people, this is who I'm going to write about. That's not who I'm going to write about. So, but it hasn't been declared official yet, so I can't talk about it. I will say that I think readers will be pleased with some of the news that I will be sharing soon. So that's all I
can
tell you.
That is not an answer.
It's not an answer, and I apologize. I'm sorry, not sorry. How's that?
Okay, so if anybody wants to know, they're an aspiring writer. How many rejections did you receive before you were published?
I really can't even count the number of rejections I received before I was published. I wrote for 5 years before I got an agent, I think it was, or maybe that was before I was published. I don't know. I had written 7 books before I got an agent, and all 7 of those were rejected all over the place by agents, by publishers alike. And then my agent signed me on, and it took us 2 years from that point to sell a book. So expect lots of rejections. It really helped me grow and develop a thick skin, because when your books are published and then you get scathing reviews or people who hate it because you can't please everyone, what some people love, others will hate, it really helps you be okay with that and to realize that writing is subjective, and you just have to write what you love and everything else will fall into place and it'll all be okay.
Okay, somebody wants to know about the angels.
The angels of the dark. I'm going to be absorbing them into the Lords of the Underworld book, so you will begin to see them start to appear more and more into the Lords books, and they will also have their own stories, but I think it will be under the Lords of the Underworld umbrella from now on. So I love those angels, and so I'm not abandoning them. I promise you they will start showing up in the upcoming books.
Okay, this is someone who loves Alice in Zombieland series.
Yay!
And wants to know when you will be writing more young adults.
So I just turned in a young adult book. It's the third book in my Everlife series, and its title is Everlife. And then I will be launching a brand new YA series. I can't talk about it yet, but it will be my creepiest, most romantic, sassiest YA series yet. I am so beyond excited for it. I cannot wait to share the details. But again, I'm sorry, not sorry, that I can't tell you more. But yes, there will be more young adult books coming up. And if you loved Alice, I think you will love this new series. So.
Okay, someone wants to know your writing schedule and how do you start a first draft?
Okay, my writing schedule is I write every day, 7 days a week, when I'm working on a rough draft, and I will write at least a chapter a day. Depends on how long that takes me. If it doesn't take me long, I'll write more. If it does, then it does. But what was the rest of the question? I've already forgotten.
What was your writing schedule?
Oh, okay, so that is my writing schedule. It will take me 2 to 3 months to write a rough draft, or to turn in the first draft, because a lot of times I have other books come in other series that I have to edit and revise at the same time, so I'll have to put something on hold and then go back to it. But yeah, a chapter a day, every day.
This is someone who wants to know what your 2018 books will be.
My 2018, that means, okay, so that is next year. Sometimes I get my time, my years mixed up, as well as my days and my months and my weeks. Okay, so next year will be a brand new Lords of the Underworld book. It will be Everlife, the third book in the Everlife series, and third and final. There will be a mass market paranormal romance, right, as well. And it will be a brand new book, but I don't know who the stars of it will be. So more on that to come.
Okay, this is a question. I'm going to pan over to this poster right here so you know what we're talking about.
Oh, yes.
Someone wants to know if you'll ever write any more Playing with Fire.
I would absolutely love to. I so love that series. I love the characters. I love the world. I love that the possibilities are limitless. I mean, all of these different powers and Belle Jameson. I mean, come on. A flaky little girl who can control the four elements. Yes, I'm on board. And then Rome Masters is one of my favorite heroes that I've ever written. He's like William, I guess, like who passes his brother. They've probably, their personalities have bled into each other a bit. But yes, I would love to. Nothing is in the works right now, but I never say never with that series because I would like to return to it.
Okay, what or who is your favorite lord?
My favorite lord is actually a non-lord. It's William. I love his irreverence. I mean, he's just as likely to stab his friend as his enemy, just for grins and giggles. He's undefeatable. I mean, you can cut off both of his feet and he'll still find a way to stand back up. I mean, I adore this character. So, but if I had to choose one of the Lords of the Underworld, it would probably be Cameo right now because she's my lady. She can hold her own with the guys, and in fact, she can send them to their knees. So, I love my girl Cameo.
Okay, Cheryl just said she just dropped off her book plate, so thank you to Cheryl.
Oh, thank you, Cheryl. I so appreciate that.
But can you tell people what that program is and how they can find out more about it?
Okay, absolutely. Okay, so with my last few book releases, I have asked for readers to volunteer. Oh, here's my Thor bear. He's a little too... Okay. He demands certain pets. I had asked for readers to volunteer to take signed book plates and bookmarks to bookstores on the week of the Darkest Promises release. And so we had around 350 readers volunteer for that. They each got 5 signed book plates and 5 bookmarks. They go to the local bookstores and they place them inside of the book. So you have the choice if you buy one, if you want to adhere this signed sticker to the book or not. That way you have the opportunity to buy a signed book. And then they send me pictures of the bookstore's location so that I can inform other readers to go get, if they want a signed book, where they can go get one. I love it. I'm so grateful to readers for doing it. And so I think it allows other readers an opportunity that they may not have had otherwise. So thank you so much to all of you who do it. And so yeah, if you want a signed copy of The Darkest Promise, watch my Facebook page for information about where you can find them.
Someone asked if Thor is spoiled.
No, not even a little.
There are a lot of people who just want to say hi, everywhere from Louisiana to Wales. So if you'll just wave
yes.
to everybody.
Hi, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in all over the world. I so appreciate you. I really, really do.
Okay, so this is a person who wants to know who your favorite writer is, and we're just going to take my name out of it.
Okay.
So. Because we obviously know it's
yes, I love, in fact, I just want to throw this out there. Jill Monroe's book, Naked Pursuit, was just made into a Lifetime movie. And it was so incredible and fantastic. I have been telling people it is one of the best things that has ever happened to me so far. To me, personally. because that was such an amazing experience. But if you haven't read Cressley Cole, her Immortals After Dark series is... amazing. If you love the Lords of the Underworld, you will love the Immortals After Dark. PC Cast is an amazing author, and her daughter Kristen Cast. Roxanne St. Clair, Kristen Painter. I love Karen Monning, J.R. Ward. Nalini Singh has a brand new book out today. She's an incredible writer. There are just... And I know I'm forgetting 1,000 names because I was a reader before I was a writer. And I have so many favorites. But those, just to name a few, those are some incredible writers.
And this is somebody who wants to know, how long will the Lords of the Underworld series continue? It is their favorite, and they don't want it to end.
Oh, good. As long as readers are loving it, I'm going to keep putting it out there. So, you know, writing is a business as much as a passion. And so if the sales aren't there, you don't want to, you know, put your time into that. But so if readers are still loving, I'm still, I'm happy to write until I have paired off every single person in the Lords of the Underworld universe.
Well, we're almost out of time, and we have had some new people join. So if you want to tell them about the contest one more time.
Oh, yes. I'm having a contest. So like my Facebook page and post a question on the thread of this video to enter to win one of 10 of these little packets. It is the first chapter of The Darkest Promise with my notes included. And one lucky winner will get to choose from the Lords of the Underworld backlist any one of these beautiful hardbacks. And so if you, I know that some of you were asking, you know, why were the Lords of the Underworld suddenly turned into hardbacks? And because you like to have a complete collection of one type, either a mass marketed trade or a hardback. And so we heard you, and we are now offering all of the Lords of the Underworld as hardbacks. I adore them. I mean, I'm just over the moon about how they turned out. And so is Thor.
Well, that was the final question, is what is your favorite Lords of the Underworld book cover?
My favorite cover, you know, I will probably always have a soft spot for the very first one, The Darkest Night. When I got that book cover, I almost melted from joy. I was so excited. Oh my goodness, I have loved just so many of them, but I love The Darkest Kiss because they actually matched his eyes to his description, one blue and one brown on the cover. Oh my gosh, and The Darkest Pleasure. I'll just start naming them all. How about that? I love The Darkest Night best, plus all the others. All right, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. I so appreciate you, and I look forward to seeing your reviews and thoughts on The Darkest Promise, and I hope you have just the best day.